There are some mistakes that people make when they resize photos for Instagram using Photoshop. And in this video, I'm going to mention the top three mistakes that you want to avoid before uploading to Instagram. The number one frequent mistake that I see in my feed when scrolling on Instagram is the fact that people don't crop their photos properly when using Photoshop. They actually don't use the aspect ratios recommended by Instagram in order to avoid having those white bars on the sides of the photos and even at the top and bottom. This is affecting the viewing experience of that photo when someone is scrolling, and that could lead to less engagement, likes, comments, and followers. Now, you don't want that, right? Me neither. So first, just write down all the aspect ratios on paper. I know you will learn them quickly, but it's better to have them in front of you when you crop your photos for Instagram. It's much easier. Also, take a look at what Instagram says here. Upload a photo with a width of at least 1080 pixels with an aspect ratio between 1.91 by 1 and 4 by 5. And that's the confusing part for most of us, that between word, right? Don't tell anyone. But until this point, I didn't use the 1.91 by 1 aspect ratio. But I used the 16 by 9 and it worked just fine. As an example, let's see how we could crop this photo properly with Photoshop. Activate the crop tool with C on the keyboard and make sure you don't have this box checked, because otherwise the areas outside the crop will be deleted. So if you want to come back and make some adjustments, don't tick this box. From this list, I will choose the 1:1 ratio, which means I will have a square crop. I can reposition the image if I want to, and I press Enter to confirm the crop. I can also experiment with a 4:5 crop, which is also accepted by Instagram. This is my favorite because it gives you more room for other details in the photo, and also it takes much more space in Instagram's feed so the viewer can really focus on your post. You can also try a 5:4 crop just by clicking on this icon with the two arrows. This is awesome if you want to put some text here on the right side, but you can also resize the crop and create a more of a close-up look for your subject. There's another aspect ratio that Instagram recommends, and you could try it, and that is 1.91 by 1, like I said earlier. Let's just enter these values in the crop boxes here. And this is the aspect ratio. You can resize the crop box proportionally if you want by grabbing the corners, and then you press Enter. 16 by 9 works just fine if you want to try it on Instagram, especially if you're a landscape photographer and you can post your photo in camera for a wide aspect ratio. But to be honest with you guys, these days I just stick to square, so 1:1, or 4:5 aspect ratios. This is what I prefer at the moment. Mistake number 2 and number 3 are strongly connected to each other. But let me explain. So mistake number 2 is that people don't sharpen their photos before uploading them to Instagram. And sharpening means that the photo is more crisp, more clear, it has more details. It pops out even more. Look at the difference between a photo that is not sharpened and how it looks when sharpening was applied in Photoshop. You can see much more details and the image will stand out even more in Instagram's feed. So don't forget to sharpen. Mistake number 3 is that people are sharpening photos before resizing them in Photoshop. And look, I don't want to start a very technical discussion right now, but trust me, the sharpening stage should be made after resizing the photo. So first you resize the photo by going to Image, Image Resize. You enter 1080 pixels on width, make sure this chain is active to keep proportions, and just press OK. The photo is resized, so now is the right time to sharpen it and emphasize some details. Make sure the layer with the image is selected, and if it's the only layer in the document, you can just simply duplicate it with Ctrl plus J. If you have multiple layers in the document, like in this example, maybe some adjustment layers, just select the top layer and create a stamped visible layer by pressing Ctrl Shift Alt and E. In the next step, you need to desaturate this new layer by pressing Ctrl, Shift, and U. Right-click on the new layer, convert it to a smart object, and now you can go to Filter, Other, High Pass. I usually keep this value on 0.3 pixels, press OK, and then put this layer onto Linear Light Blending mode. From here, you can control the opacity of the effect very easily, and you can also double-click on the high pass filter and change its values, even though I don't recommend choosing high numbers here because the result can actually ruin your photo. Click on this video next because I show you the best way to resize photos and how to save or export them for Instagram. I'm Christy, catch you in the next one.